So what's up, guys? Welcome to Tito Wilson Designs YouTube. It's been a while since we've done a YouTube video, and this summer there's going to be a lot more videos because I am standing inside my summer's project, my side project, on top of our coffee company that we own, on top of Tito Wilson Designs, being booked out already past summer with furniture builds. But I'm standing in it. Let me show you what we got. So last weekend, I had this idea to go get, sorry, you can tell I'm not a YouTuber. My hands are in everything. Anyways, had this idea to go get a 1950s, very, very rusty horse trailer that we are going to, when I say me, I mean myself, going to refurb this into something. That's if I can figure out everything. But yeah, so starting here soon, we're going to be, I say we, I mean me, going to be tackling this project. I'm gonna walk you through, kind of show you some of the things that I know are gonna have to change. And while you're watching this, if you know more than I do, comment in the comments below, message me, let me know, give me some guidance, because I know I'm gonna need it. So but yeah, right back there is where Tito Wilson Designs happens. And right out here is where this is gonna happen. So I'm gonna flip you around and we're gonna show you around this trailer. So I know that these floors are gonna have to be all taken out. They are all rotted to shreds. We'll say shreds. And then the floor right there is all coming out. I have been in here a lot. I'm a big guy, so they're not like too bad, but it's questionable. So this right here, I'm gonna take all this out, remove all of that. There's this hole up here in the ceiling that my guess is there is a vent or something there. My plan right now is to take all of this out. Leave the only metal part I'm planning on leaving is the ceiling. Taking all this out, I'm gonna do windows right here. Do a big window right there. Do a big window, matching window right here. Cool floors, do a cool ceiling. Yeah. And I'm gonna have to learn how to weld, because there are structural places like right here that I'll need to get, cut that out, get new metal, weld that in. Right there, I have to fix that. Fix that right there. On the other side, I'll take you on the other side here, but somebody hit that a long time ago, and you could tell the dent, how it curves and it concaves in and then goes back out. And then this structural metal so far looks okay. So I think, I hope I can leave that. Just have to clean it up. This stuff looks okay. Have to clean it up. Another big problem is this piece right here. I'm gonna have to either fix that by welding together, or just, I'll probably just cut it all out completely and replace it. And the thing is, I don't know anything about welding. I've never welded a day in my life. But 5 years ago, I didn't know anything about oak and poplar, wenge or walnut or live edge or any of that. So I'm not scared of a challenge, but there is stuff to learn. So let me take you on the outside and show you something. Right here is where they bondoed, I think it's called bondo, the crud out of this dent. I mean, this is probably quarter inch thick of bondo right here. So I'm gonna remove all of that side paneling, all of this side paneling. I haven't decided if I wanna leave these and just restore them, the fenders, or there's something cool I might wanna do instead of that. Haven't decided yet. But here, I wanna put windows all in here, curved windows, take that all out, do something cool up front here. This door will not be here anymore. Do a cool big window there, same on the other side. I guess I haven't do that. And these tires, man, these are two different size tires, same on the other side. So I'm gonna have to get all new tires. I haven't even looked at the axles. Not the axles, the axles are fine. My buddy went with me and told me they're fine. They just need to be cleaned up. I haven't looked at it here, see how rusted or anything. But that's on the to-do list, just take those off. And then the doors are gonna come all off and I'm gonna do something fun, design there. Man, when I got this, it was still like in the upper 60s, 70s. But this week it's been in like the 80s, lower 90s here in Knoxville, Tennessee. And it is really bringing out the aroma of the horse trailer, if you know what I'm saying. So these wood floors have to go, but I'm excited about this. Nervous, obviously, but excited. Give me something to do on the side, you know, while my glue ups are drying or epoxy's curing or finish is drying. Plus, it allows me to maybe do some YouTube content that you guys will actually like and want to watch. So, in the comments below, on my Instagram, here on YouTube, Facebook, whatever, let me know what kind of things you would like to see during this refurb. My initial thought is to break it down into sections. Each video that I post would be a different category. Like the first one would be the demolition. One will be just all the metal restoration. One will be woodwork. One will be paint prep, things like that. But tell me what you think. Let me know. This is just the introductory to this 1950s horse trailer that we are going to be refurbing. Slowly. Let me say that slowly, because this is just something we're going to do when I have time. Like I said, we have a coffee company that we started in January and it's taken off. Tita Wilson Designs is booked out months and months. So, yeah, let me know what you want to see with this. I'm excited. And let me know color schemes and ideas for design. We have a few in mind that I'll be posting and trying to get your opinions. But yeah, so it's like really hot. So excuse the sweat, but I'm excited. I'm Tito, 1950s horse trailer. You've seen it. Now, when it's all done, you're gonna be staying inside some cool place right here, man. All right, follow along, like, share, subscribe to this channel if you want to follow along. I never thought I'd be saying those words because I didn't want to be a YouTube person, but like, share, subscribe, guys. Let's tag along.
Yesterday I got lost in the circus, feeling like such a mess. And now I'm down, I'm just hanging on the corner. I can't help but reminisce. 'Cause when you mama called, she said that you're downstairs crying.